In the last episode, we installed quite a few mods to improve the San Andreas experience. I'm sure once you finish this guide, you will likely go ahead and install a load of other mods which are newfound modding knowledge. However, it is very likely you'll eventually install mods that maybe conflict with each other. Or maybe you'll install a mod that doesn't work too great and crashes the game after a while. Or something like that. It's bound to happen, especially when there's nearly 20 years of mods made for the game, and things have changed a lot over the years. Some things just won't work that well, especially the older stuff. So it's good to know how you can diagnose and solve crashes yourself, as it'll massively reduce your frustration with the game, and will help you get the game back to a working state much quicker. So in this video, that's exactly what I'm going to teach you. So welcome to the fifth episode of the Ultimate Modding Guide for San Andreas. In recent years, there's now actually mods that help you diagnose crashes much quicker. The main one being Crash Info. If the game crashes with this mod installed, the mod will show a window with information about the crash afterwards. A lot of crashes for San Andreas have been documented by the community, and this mod contains a list of those documented crashes. When the game crashes, the mod can see what the error was, then checks the list to see if the error is in the documented list. If it is, the mod will tell you what the problem is, and if there's a solution, it'll tell you what the solution is too. I'd consider Crash Info an essential mod, so I'd always have it installed if I was you. The only reason it wasn't in the guide earlier was because I wanted to cover it properly once you had your game set up correctly. Let's install the mod and I'll give you an example. Step 1. Download the mod from the link in the description. Step 2. Open the mod archive, then open the SA folder. The mod has two language options, English and Portuguese. Pick whichever you understand best. Open the mod folder and then copy everything from the folder into your San Andreas folder. The mod has to go to your San Andreas folder, as it can't be installed with mod loader or inside your scripts folder. Anyway, the mod is installed, so I'm going to show you an example of how you can use this. I've intentionally made a broken mod and installed it with mod loader. Let's see what happens when I try to launch the game. As you can see, the game has crashed, and the mod has told us the potential problem. When trying to read some text, the text did not exist. It could be for several reasons. Solution: invalid timecyc.dat file. It happens because there is some error, for example, some line is missing in your timecyc.dat. And that's exactly the issue. I removed some lines from the timecyc.dat file and installed it inside mod loader. The game is trying to look for specific lines, but they're not there, so it crashes. Crash Info in this instance can tell us exactly what's wrong. Keep in mind, it won't always know what the issue is, as there's thousands of different ways your game can crash and they're not all documented, but it can give you a decent idea a lot of the time. Also, the mod is originally Portuguese, so the translations might not contain the best English. But like I said before, you should get an idea of what the issue is. What Crash Info says might not always be entirely correct either, however. For example, in this instance, the game is crashing when I try to select a weapon. I know the issue is actually with a weapon.dat file I've installed with mod loader. However, Crash Info thinks the issue is with an animation file. This is true to an extent. The issue is with animations, but not an animation file. I removed the lines that tells the game which animation to use for certain weapons inside weapon.dat, which I installed inside mod loader. If I remove this file, the game will no longer crash when selecting weapons. So crash info was kinda right, but not entirely. This is rare, but if you run into instances like this and you solve the issue yourself, be sure to report it to MixMods so they can update the crash list with your problem and solution. Speaking of solving the issue yourself, what if crash info can't tell you exactly what the problem is? Well, there's a few other ways to diagnose what's causing your game to crash. There's another mod called SCOR-Log, which is specifically for checking which Clio script is potentially causing your game to crash. Crash info can also tell you if it's possibly a Clio script causing crashes, but SCOR-Log can narrow it down to a single script. So let's install this and I'll show you how it works. Step 1. Download the mod from the link in the description. Step 2. Open the archive you just downloaded. The mod has an English and a Portuguese version. Pick whichever you understand best. Once you've picked, copy the SCOR-Log folder from the archive into your mod loader folder. Step 3. Open the SCOR-Log folder in your mod loader folder, then open SCOR-Log.ini with a text editor. Near the top, there's a line about enabling or disabling SCOR-Log processing. Change enabled equals true to enabled equals false. This disables the mod. We're doing this because the mod can actually impact your performance. So only enable this if you're trying to diagnose a crash and you think it's possibly a Clio script. If your game isn't crashing, make sure this is disabled. You can also type SCORL while in game to enable or disable SCOR-Log while the game is running. The setting is saved, so be sure to disable it once your crash is fixed. Anyway, I'm going to give you a quick example of how SCOR-Log works when enabled, using a test script that's actually provided in the mod archive. This test script crashes the game on launch, and it's called testcrash.cs. So if I launch the game, it'll obviously crash. Crash info shows first, telling me that the issue is caused by a Clio script, and to also use SCOR-Log to find out which script specifically. If I close the game, SCOR-Log will pop up, telling us which script is causing the crash. As you can see, it says crash on script name test CRA. As you can see, it only shows 7 characters of the Clio script name, but you should still know after this which Clio script is causing the crash. Once you remove the script that SCOR-Log lists, the crashing should hopefully stop. If for some reason SCOR-Log doesn't pop up after a crash, go to the SCOR-Log folder in ModLoader and open SCOR-Log.log with any text editor. Scroll down to the bottom and check the last script that was loaded. As you can see here, the last script that was loaded was the test crash script. You can tell this likely caused the crash because it didn't finish processing. If the SCOR-Log shows that all scripts have finished processing at the very end, well then it's very unlikely a Clio script is causing a crash. Again, make sure you keep SCOR-Log disabled unless you're trying to diagnose a crash, as it can hurt performance. Okay, so what if crash info and SCOR-Log can't help you diagnose the crash? Well then you can resort to trial and error. So here's how I typically do this. First, I go to my mod loader configuration file, and then near the top, I change ignore all mods from false to true. This basically disables all of your mods in mod loader. I then launch the game and check if it works. If it does, you know the mod that's causing the problem is installed with mod loader. After this, I go back and change ignore all mods back to false, re-enabling all your mods. So, how do you pin down which mod is causing the issue? Well, for me, I literally just go to my mod loader folder and delete batches of mods at a time. Don't worry, as long as the folders aren't massive in size, they'll simply go to your recycling bin. Anyway, I'll highlight 5, maybe 10 mods at a time, delete them, and then test the game. If it's still crashing after you delete a batch, undo the deletion so those mod folders come back, then do another batch. Do this until you delete a batch of mods which stops the crashing. Once you find out which batch of mods is causing the crashes, go through the batch one by one, deleting a mod, testing, deleting a mod, testing, until the crashes stop. This might seem like a tedious process, but you can usually figure out which mod it is in 5 to 10 minutes. It's possible two mods might be causing crashes, and you might overlook one while using this method, but it's usually unlikely if you're testing most of your mods as you install them. If the crash is still happening, even after you disabled all of your mod loader mods through the configuration file, it obviously means a mod outside mod loader is causing the issue. This shouldn't be too hard to narrow down, as I'd say 90% of your mods will be installed with mod loader. If you need to figure out which mod outside a mod loader is causing a crash, check your backup of San Andreas, which we made earlier in the guide, and compare which files are different or new in comparison to the backup. Remove these files as you test, until the crashing stops. And the last suggestion I have for you is to simply test as you go. Try to avoid installing multiple mods at a time with no testing. Instead, install one mod, test your game to check if it works, then install another mod. Doing this means you know if there's an issue with a mod right away, rather than later when you have a huge number of mods installed and you're not sure which one is causing an issue. This won't always work, as some mods may only crash in certain instances, but it definitely helps. One thing you need to know is, some mods just aren't made well. There won't always be a solution to a crash. Some mods will just crash no matter what you do at some point. I'd recommend trying to avoid mods made before, say, 2009 or so, especially ClioScripts. While they're not all bad, it's just so much more likely you'll run into a poorly made mod from that time that will cause you issues with your game. It's important to make sure you have all your mods up to date, at least in most instances, as usually the latest versions of mods are the most stable. In the next episode, I'll show you the places I'd recommend downloading mods from, and I'll give you some extra tips before we wrap this guide up. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.